Hi, I'm Mark. In this video, I'm going to explain why PE ratio is a bad indicator and what you should look at instead. And when it comes to analyzing the value of a stock or comparing companies in terms of value, without a doubt, the price to earnings ratio is the most popular metric. But despite its popularity, there are some mathematical problems that can make this indicator useless in practice. Now, first of all, what is the PE ratio? PE ratio is a company's share price divided by its earnings. A PE of 20 means a company is worth 20 times its earnings. All other things equal, low PE means undervalued stock, high PE means overvalued stock. It's simple and easy, isn't it? Or is it? Assume there are five companies, A, B, C, D, and E. All companies share the same characteristics and trade at $100 each. Now, you use PE ratio to make your investment decision. Between company A and B, B is the better option, and you agree because B earns more. But how about company C, D, and E? Well, it looks confusing. You might want to go for company E, but E turns out to be the worst. To understand this confusion better, let's inspect the relationship between earnings and PE ratio. Now, we plot earnings per share on the x-axis, PE ratio on the y-axis, and we hold the share price constant. Now, can you imagine what it looks like? When we look at the positive side of earnings per share, as we move further towards zero, the PE increases and goes to positive infinity. When we look at the negative side of the earnings per share, as we move further towards zero, the PE ratio decreases and goes to negative infinity. Now, this behavior is problematic. For example, Amazon's earnings per share have been pretty stable around zero. But this steadiness is not reflected by the PE ratio. In fact, PE jumps between large negative and large positive values when neither earnings nor prices change much. Now, if you had excluded Amazon only due to its erratic behaving PE ratio, you would have missed out greatly. The PE ratio can be misleading for varying earnings per share. So, what can we do? Well, a simple transformation changes everything. Flipping over the PE ratio creates earnings yield. Now, earnings yield, or EY, is earnings divided by price. An earnings yield of 7% means that for a $100 investment, you get $7 in earnings. Now, let's look at the relationship between earnings yield and earnings. As before, we plot earnings on the x-axis and earnings yield on the y-axis, and we compare it to the PE ratio. Earnings yield has a linear relationship with earnings. So when a company's earnings don't change much, earnings yield reflects that steadiness. This property about earnings yield makes stock comparison fair, and we can include all companies in our analysis, regardless of whether their earnings are positive, negative, or zero. For earnings yield, it also always holds that all other things equal, high means good and low means bad. And that is simple and easy. ShareLab provides earnings yield along with other helpful indicators for free. Visit ShareLab.com to analyze your favorite U.S. stocks and get access to indicator-based research. Now that's it for PE ratio. Thank you for listening.